Hello and welcome back to the channel Englishpedia by SR. I hope all of you are doing good. This video is on academic series and is on rhetoric or figures of speech. Two videos on figures of speech are already up on my channel. They are on simile and metaphor and oxymoron. In today's video, we will discuss two figures based on the principle of contrast or difference. They are climax and anticlimax. So if you like this video, you know the drill. You need to like, share and subscribe to the channel for more such academic content. So without much further delay, let's jump into the video. And the video that are already uploaded in the channel, the link will be given in the description box. Do follow them. The word climax has its root in the Greek word climax, which means a ladder. What do we do using a ladder? We go from the lower step to the higher ones. So similarly, we use the figure of speech climax to represent ideas or words from the lower ones having the lowest importance to the higher one. We arrange them in an ascending order of importance. Climax, therefore, creates a sense of suspense among the readers, and the readers wait to know the last or the end or the most impressive idea. I have given a diagrammatic expression of using climax in a sentence. See, we are moving towards from the lower one to the higher one. Let us now look at a few examples where climax has been used. Example number one, a hurt to resolve, a head to contrive, and a hand to execute. If you do some works, you exactly follow these three steps sequentially. You first make plans or decide what to do. You then make strategies, and then you execute or perform the works. So making plans or deciding what to do is at the lower base, and execution is at the highest one. So here we have used climax. We are moving from the lower ones to the higher ones. Example number two, to know, to esteem, to love. So these are the sequential three steps which are used in falling in love. You know a person, you start respecting him or her, and then you fall in love. So these are, knowing is again at the lower base and loving is at the higher base. Example number three, he was a thief, a plunderer, and an assassin. So thief, plunderer, and assassin are again arranged sequentially in the order of ascending importance. Thief, plunderer, and assassin, they are arranged at the level of the seriousness of crime. Thief is less serious a crime, being thief. Being plunderer is then at the second level of importance, and assassin is at the highest level of importance. Example number four. Some books are to be tasted, others to be swallowed, and some few to be chewed and digested. This is a very important and memorable statement by Bacon, where we are having again the sequential ideas arranged in an ascending order of importance. So some books, those are not so important, you read them, you flip the pages through. Then some which are comparatively more important, you read them, you swallow them. And the most important ones, you read them diligently, that are chewed and digested. Next example, to strive, to seek, to find, and not to yield. This is again, this example shows how to fight the odds in life. You have to strive, you have to keep seeking, and you will not surrender to the adversities in life. So these are again arranged in an ascending order of importance, keeping the lowest important one at the base and the highest one at the top. After reading climax, let's know what anticlimax is. Anticlimax is also known as bathos, and this is exactly the opposite figure of speech of climax. Here we observe a sudden fall from the most impressive idea or word to the least one, and it causes a ludicrous laughter effect. This figure is mostly used intentionally to create an effect of laughter. Here I have again shown a diagrammatic expression of anticlimax where there is a fall from the peak to the base. Let us now look at a few examples of anticlimax. Example number one. She lost her husband, her children, and her handkerchief. So here, losing husband and children are the most important and intensified loss, where losing handkerchief is the most ludicrous thing. So this sequence actually creates an effect of laughter. Losing husband is at the peak, and then there is a sudden fall from husband to handkerchief. This is the use of anticlimax in a sentence. Example number two. The hurricane tore up oaks by the roots, dismantled churches, laid villages waste, and overturned a haystack. So the loss or the disaster is the effect is from the highest one to the lowest important one. Uprooting trees, destruction of churches are the most important ones. They are at the top, they are at the peak, and then there is a sudden fall of destruction of a haystack. This is again an example of anticlimax where ludicrous effect has been intentionally made to create a sense of laughter. Let us now look at example number three. Whether the nymph shall break Diana's law or some frail china jar receive a flaw. Breaking Diana's law means breaking chastity or compromising chastity. So that has been compared to a china jar receiving a flaw. So the most important loss or compromising chastity, this is at the peak, and then there is a sudden fall from that to a china jar which is going to break. So again, this is an example of anticlimax which is creating a sense of laughter. Let's look at the last example. Poets and pigs are not appreciated until they are dead. So poets, important feature, important beings in our society, and then pigs, which are not so important. They are contrasted together, and there is a sudden fall from poets to pigs, and both of them are not appreciated until they are dead. The poets are appreciated posthumously, and pigs are appreciated when they are served on a platter. So let's now look at the examples which you need to work out on. These are the homework, or you can call them exercises. Here are some four sentences. You need to identify whether these sentences contain climax or anticlimax. I hope you have a clear idea now regarding the concepts of climax and anticlimax, and you will be able to identify them easily in a sentence. Work out on the examples, the exercises that I have given, and let me know the answers in the comment section. Till then, take care and wait for the next video to come. Take care and happy learning.